Hello students, today we will continue chapter 2 of geography. This is the second video of this chapter, globes, latitudes and longitudes. In previous video we have understood the concept of globe. Now we will understand why there was a need of imaginary lines. As we have read about the axis, you can see that axis connected the poles, north to south. But in real there is no such needle. Now we will read about such more imaginary lines like equator, the biggest latitude, longitude. Now the question arises, why there is need of such imaginary lines? So answer maybe or answer will be to find the location, date and the time of a place, we need these imaginary lines. Now with the help of an example, I will make you understand. Suppose your friend want to visit, so how he will or she will come to your home? First you have to give your address. In that address, first you will mention your house number, then your colony name, then your city name, then only he or she will able to come. But if any parameter will be missing, then he or she will not able to come and visit you. In the same way, to search the places on the earth, these imaginary lines are formed. Let us see which was the first imaginary line that was first formed. So that is equator. What is the meaning of equator? Equate means to divide into two equal parts. So the equator is an imaginary line which divide the earth into two equal parts. First is northern hemisphere and second is southern hemisphere. What is hemisphere? The half circle. You can see this is called hemisphere. This line is very important reference line to locate place on the earth. Now our next imaginary line are latitudes. What are latitudes? Coming to latitudes, all parallel circles from equator up to the poles, you can see here, are called, from equator to poles, north pole and to the south pole, these are the parallels, or we can call latitudes, are called parallels of latitudes and are measured in degrees. You can see 10, 20, 30, 40, 0 degree liquid equator, then moving to poles. Now when we have divided the earth into two equal parts, halves, it has become little bit easier for us to locate any place on the earth. Now we can at least tell whether the place is in the place which we are searching, whether the place is in the northern hemisphere or the southern hemisphere. Now if we want to find any place in the northern hemisphere, we have to find that how much north we have to go, and if we have to find the place in the southern hemisphere, to how much south we have to go. So from the center, how much north and how much south we have to go to find that place. So we will draw, we will, from the center we will draw an imaginary line, or we will draw a degree up to that place. But we should know that whether we have to go to north or we have to come to south. Suppose I have drawn
70 degree. Now from the center we will draw an angle and we will go to that place. Now if I have taken one 45 degree, if I have to go 45 degree to where, whether I have to go north, whether I have to come to south. So suppose I have to come to south, let say 45 south. As we know, our earth is sphere, so the place lying on the point, this whole point, our earth is sphere, in this the points lying in this whole sphere will be of 45. So we try to find the place, we not only get the place, we are not getting a particular 45 here, 45 here. We are not getting a particular place, we are getting a whole circle. All the places are of 45. We can see that we are cutting the slices of the earth horizontally. The equator represent the 0 degree. See here, the equator represent the 0 degree latitude. 90 degree north latitude makes the north pole, and 90 degree south latitude marks the south pole. All the parallels north of the, means the parallel which are lying in the north upward, they will call northern latitudes. They runs horizontally to the equator, from the equator to up to the pole, and all the lines which are lying at the southern pole from the equator are called south latitudes. Now next, the value of each latitude is followed by degrees. I have already said these things, that all the values you can see here, measure all the values of latitudes are measured by the degrees, north or the south. Whether you are going to north or you are north, towards the north and towards the south, they are marked with the degrees. We can have an example here. You can see that this image. For example, both Chandrapur in Maharashtra, India, and Belo Horizonte in Brazil, South America, are located on 20 degree latitude. They are saying only 20 degree latitude. They are not telling where Chandrapur is located, whether it is in north or south, and where is Belo Horizonte, in south or north, 20 degree. But the former is, former means that Chandrapur. Tell the name of Chandrapur. So first, the former one is Chandrapur in Maharashtra, is in 20 north of the equator. 20 north. Then we get some place in this hole, something 20 north. And the latter is 20 south of the equator now, below horizontal in 20 south. So at least we are able to know that Chandrapur is in the northern hemisphere and below horizontal is in the southern hemisphere. We therefore say that Chandrapur is in the situated in the 20 degree north and below horizontal is situated in at 20 degree south latitude. That as we move, we say away from the, and one thing more, somewhere in this whole latitude Chandrapur can be located. It can be anywhere, but at least we are able to know that it is in the northern hemisphere and below is in this whole latitude in the southern hemisphere. Now coming to, as we move towards the equator, coming again to this figure, as we move towards the equator, the size of the parallels of latitude decreases, means from 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and then a single point. And equator is the largest latitude, and this equator is the biggest slice. Okay, understand? Now, coming to the most important topic, important parallels. We have discussed latitude. Now, important parallels of a latitude. Beside the equator, the North Pole 90 North and South Pole 90 South, there are four more important parallels of latitude. Except these, four more are important. The first one is, you can see here, the first one is Tropic of Cancer, that lies 23 half from center, 23 half north. Then downwards, Tropic of Capricorn, from the center towards the south, Tropic of Capricorn. Then from the center towards the north, Arctic Circle, 66 half north. And from the center towards the south, 66 half south is Antarctica, Antarctic Circle. And you should know that only the Tropic of Cancer, which is 23 half, passes through India. It passes from 8 states of India: Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Tripura and Mizoram. These are the 8 states from where the Tropic of Cancer pass through. Okay beta, thank you for today. This much. Now we will continue with the next topic, longitude. Thank you. Have a nice day.